I'm Shweta. Welcome back to my podcast, Art, Faith and Stories. You're listening to my third episode, Create with the Creator. Today, I'm going to talk about one of my favorite paintings, Draw Me Close. This painting is beautifully adorning the walls of my beloved friends Ashish and Anugrah in Gurgaon. This painting was actually inspired by a song written by Kelly Carpenter. He wrote this song in the midst of his busy life serving God as a worship leader and felt that God wanted more of him rather than doing things for him. Kelly wrote this song as a prayer to God, fallen on his knees and crying out his heart in surrender. As I talk about this song, I want to draw your attention to the cover pic of this episode. It's an image of the painting I'm going to talk about. Dear listeners, before I share about the painting, I would like you all to come along with me to have a glimpse of my life through a small window of 2015, when I painted this beautiful and lively abstract painting. I had gone through some really painful and tough times in the past 2 years. Times when I felt God's presence the least, because of my own foolishness. I was angry, bitter, and went far away from His presence. Honestly speaking, it was very difficult figuring out my faith and my walk with God. During these years, I tried to start painting again twice, but it turned out to be very ugly, scary, and messy. Maybe just like my own life, where God's beauty departed me and my art. Draw Me Close to You, my most beautiful painting, birthed at this point of my life. This was the third attempt to start painting again, and this time it turned out to be a comeback. Friends, have you ever experienced listening to your own self? I have, many times, especially when I'm talking in a flow, or praying, or sharing my life story with someone. I feel this unique flow that just takes over. And oftentimes I say to myself, "Oh, I just heard myself." Something lights upon my heart, a special word or phrase or maybe a thought. And on the other hand, have you ever experienced when you're listening and you're not listening? Your heart, your intent is not in the meaning of the words. You're just listening. Like your music playing in the car and you're somewhere else in your thoughts? Unintentional singing, listening, chanting, just unintentionally without noticing the words. You all must be thinking, what am I arriving at? Okay, just stay with me. So going back to 2015, one Sunday, I came back home from Sunday church service with this song on my lips. This was as if I was singing, but oblivious of the words and meaning. And as the day passed, the power of these words started working on me, making me aware of each word gradually. Each word was coming alive, which filled my heart with a heavy burden, and I could recognize how far I had gone from my God, who loves me unconditionally, irrevocably, and not judging me for my mistakes and wrong decisions. As I was singing, "You're all I ever wanted. You're all I ever needed. Help me know you are there. Help me know you are near. Bring me back to you." My tears started rolling down my warm, repentant cheeks. This song turned into a confession, asking God to draw me close to Him, to never let go of me. I was in eager expectation for this friendship to be re-established between me and Him. This posture of my heart took me to the canvas again, and God once again flowed through me and in me like a river, refreshing my soul, renewing my mind and heart, rekindled my passion for art, beauty, and His goodness. This song and my painting became my devotion and worship. I was creating with the Creator once again. Things which I lost once was brought back to me. all beautifully wrapped in God's amazing and forgiving love. God breathed in me a fresh lease of life. Through this painting, God revealed to me that remain in me and I will remain in you. Creates through me and I will show my beauty and goodness to people through you. My dear friends, through Him and in Him I create for His glory and His good purposes. Now, one thing I want to leave with you today. If we believe we are created by the Creator God, then create with the Creator. Remain in Him and flow with Him. In Him there is beauty. In Him there is perfection and joy. Apart from Him, we wither. We wilt. We are just ashes. But with Him, He turns all our ashes to beauty. He turns all our mournings into dancing. Dear friends, today I want to pray for you all. As we are in the midst of COVID-19 pandemic, and many of us are helpless, hopeless, and feeling stuck, and some of us may be grieving and in pain for the irreparable loss. But I assure you, even in the midst of our pain, our weakness, we can ask God to make us strong. May His Spirit rise up in our hearts, shine out of every broken place we've walked through, and let us allow His power to heal us from inside and trade the ashes of our lives for the beauty of His presence. Trade our disappointments for hope and praise. We choose to give you thanks, Lord, that you are with us in whatever we face. And you are greater than any trial. We praise you because you make all things beautiful and new. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. Thank you, dear listeners, to stay with me till the very end of this episode. We'll soon see you next Saturday with another episode on this podcast, Art, Faith and Stories. Keep listening, keep creating. Stay tuned, stay blessed.